Hello all, welcome to ERA e-learning center. Today we are going to learn the SAP notification process. In this we will cover how to create a notification in SAP. So in order to create a notification, first of all we have to type the T code required for creating a notification, which is IW21. Once we will execute the IW21, the SAP will ask us the notification type. So there are five types of notification which is configured in the SAP, but out of them totally three type of notification named as M1, M2 and M3 mostly used in the organizations. So what are M1, M2, M3? M1 is called maintenance request. As you all are aware that most of the industries, there is a already defined PEM schedule of all of the equipment installed over there. But sometimes we feel that we have to take a maintenance of equipment, but its PM02 or called plant schedule is not available in that tenure, then we can go with this M01 or M1 called maintenance request. It can be raised by the production or as well as maintenance teams. Now we cover M2. M2 is called malfunction or breakdown report or notification. So whenever we feel that there is a breakdown, it's not a feel actually, it's a current situation, then there is a breakdown in the plant and you have to notify it into the system, then it will be covered by this M2 notification. So once M2 notification is raised, it will be notified to the proper service providers. It will go to them as a notification and then they will act again this notification. Third is called activity report. So activity report is nothing but so-called low potential activities which has no production interference. So like we have to fill some oil in some of the equipment which can be done in the online, or we have to say some sample we have to collect, that will be also done in the online. We have to take a vibration, that is also done in the online. So all these things which has no production impact or low risk activities, that all will be covered in the activity report. So that notification we are going to cover in M3 type. So likewise, I have selected M1 notification and execute. In the first notification tab, here it is showing the system default number. Once you fill all the details and save, you will get a exact assigned notification number. Here you have to fill the which type of notification. So this is M1, that is already we have selected, and in this tab you have to mention the activity which we are going to take. Maintenance of packing machine. So I have found that there is some abnormality in the packing machine and I have to take its maintenance. So I have selected M1. If I will come to know that there is a breakdown, then I will select M2. And I will say that if you have to put a sticker in the M1 in the machine, packing machine, that I will select M3. So here I selected M1. Now I have to select the equipment number of this machine. Say this is the packing unit equipment number. So the function location will automatically be captured as assigned in the system. Now in the coding, I have to define the object of this notification. So object area, in the sense, what is the major area or what is the predefined, means there is a predefined elements in the SAP out of which element is applicable to this notification, that I will have to select from here. Like I will say problem detail, there is a problem notification. So I found some problem, and that is I am notifying in the system. I am not getting proper output from the packing machine, so I have defined as a problem in the packing machine output as product is not maintaining packing shape. Finally, note, if packing is not happening or something which is called to be a breakdown, that will cover in M2. But here packing is being done, but it is not in proper shape. So I am defining as a M1. Only maintenance is required. Here I have not stopped my production. Now I have to define my planner group. So planner group will be the plant where the activity has to be carried out along with the service provider selection. So service provider here is 010 is particular service group. Like we are having in our organization electrical, mechanical, instrumentation. So here we are going to type ELEC for electrical, MEC for mechanical. But in my organization we have 010. And here I have to type 0001. 0001 is my plant code. So here is planner group which I have fed in the system. Now I am going to insert main work center. Main work center, see, every plant is distributed into different work centers. Like I have a processing plant which is called where I am doing the processing of some shear pins. So shear pins are produced in my plant. Then it will be goes to the packaging unit where they are going to do the packing, and then they are going to dispatch it to the dispatching unit. Dispatching unit will further send it to the sales team. Now, this first of all is production, second is the packaging, third is the dispatch. So there are three work centers I have defined, but plant is common. So plant is 0001 is my plant. Now, three sections are there. So three sections I have named as I shown you here. This is the maintenance plant. So total plant is 0001. 3003 is my work maintenance work center. And I can say this is the work center for the packaging unit. 3002 is for the production. 3004 is for the dispatch unit. So here I am going to feed 3003. I have selected 3003. And here I have to select maintenance work center. This is equivalent to the planner group. Planner group is further divided into maintenance work center. So if you have electrical, mechanical, instrumentation, you will type here ELECH, MECH, INST like that. Enter. And system have captured these details. Now, here you will have to define. So here we are going to put the date of the notification date. Like I am raising this notification of 20/12/2018. At a time of 10 a.m. and I want this activity to be done by 28/12/2018 11 a.m. That is my required start date. Please note, required start date doesn't mean that it is actually going to start at the same time, but it is my desire that I want this job to be started by this time. So now I filled all the details here. Now my job is to save this notification. So control S. I saved this notification and I got a number. So please note down this number. So this number is so called my notification number. Now in the main screen again, now I will go to the change notification IW22. Here my notification is automatically captured. I will put enter execute. So this notification is appeared in my screen. Now, if I'm in a well-established plant where the approval hierarchy is defined, then this notification raised by any of the stakeholder, either process or maintenance, will go to the process team. They will review the requirement that is it really required or not. If it is required, then they will give a approval here and in this notification, where once they will open, here the approval tab will appear. Since in my SAP, there is no approval structure is defined, it is directly showing put in process. Otherwise, approval 1, so called NAP 1 will appear here. Once they will approve, it will go to the maintenance team or service team. Now it is in their ball that they have to decide whether they have to do this maintenance or not, or they have to justify the requirement of the same. If they are going to reject the same, here approval and reject tab will come. If they are rejecting the same, see, here you can see the approval and rejection. If you reject this notification, you will have to put a justification against the same, or if you are approving the same, then you have to click here in put in process. So now you have accepted the notification and you have to execute the order against this notification and start the work. So here now I am saving this notification. So this is the notification which I have raised for the malfunction process. Malfunction in my plant and notification number is in front of me. So here it completes the notification process of my